Aiden Miller's ghost costume flapped in the breeze as he skipped down the sidewalk, his pillowcase, heavy with candy, dragging behind him. As was typical for a 10-year-old, he loved nothing more in the world than his family, friends, and sugar. Aiden was the kind of kid that didn't dare touch a single vegetable that was served to him. Usually, he hid vegetables beneath a napkin when they appeared on his plate, though he never failed to leave room for dessert. He always wanted something sweet to bite, to put it that way. Aiden lived for Halloween. On Christmas Day, he unwrapped his presents not wearing festive pajamas, but a zombie's rags. On Spirit Day, he wore his school colors beneath a vampire cape. By September, he was loading pumpkins into his mother's shopping cart, despite her assurances that they would not last the month. It was Halloween at last, and Aiden walked beneath the waxen light of a moon half hidden by shifting clouds. Aiden wanted to make sure he would get a lot of candy, but this year it was different. Instead of sweets and sour delights, he wanted chocolate, his favorite kind of candy. Sadly, to most of the houses he went to, he got mostly lollipops, gummies, licorice, and tablet candies, and barely any chocolate bars. It wasn't what he desired, but he was still going to eat them anyway. He was going to the last house on the block, but stopped in his tracks to see what was ahead of him. He didn't recognize this house, probably because nobody lived in it. Nobody would live in a run-down house, especially if the windows were shattered and broken out, the roof almost on the verge of collapsing, and planks of the exterior of the house were missing. Well, it's worth a shot, Aiden thought. He slowly walked towards the house, climbing up the creaking wooden steps and onto the front porch. Then he knocked on the door, waiting for the door to open. A few seconds had passed, and the front door remained closed. Aiden knocked again, but yet nobody answered him. He looked into his bag. It was half empty, but not what he really wanted. He started walking away from the house to go over to the next street, but he stopped to hear a loud slam from behind him. Aiden turned his head to the house, noticing something on the front step. Whatever it was, he was intrigued to see something out of the ordinary. Maybe someone does live there, he thought. He walked back to the house, his eyes glued to a bowl of what appeared to be candy on the dirty doormat. Not just any candy, but chocolate bars of all kinds. He looked in to see Hershey's, Reese's Pieces, Snickers, Twix bars, Kit Kat bars, and many more he recognized. Atop a small mountain of chocolate bars was a note written in a simple, elegant calligraphy. Help yourself. Aiden obliged, tossing the note aside and scooping one handful, then two, into the pillowcase. His stomach rumbled and he emptied the bowl, his pillowcase so heavy it required two hands to heft it over his shoulder. He replaced the bowl and retreated from the house, whose cobwebs were not a decoration but a permanent fixture. He lumbered home, the weight of his prize reassuringly pressed against the small of his back. The night of trick-or-treating had ended, and Aiden had an entire feast, all to himself. As he got home, he sat on the couch in the living room, digging into the pillowcase to start eating. That was until his mother walked in, noticing he had just returned home.
"Wow, Aiden, did you take every chocolate bar in the world?"
his mother joked, amazed by his enormous pile of candy that sat next to him. Aiden pulled back his ghost costume, looking up at his mother with a freckled grin.
"Must have went to every house in the neighborhood. I'm a chocolate millionaire now,"
Aiden said, picking out a Snickers bar.
"Now, I don't want you eating a lot of candy before bedtime. I don't want you to get sick."
His mother left the living room, leaving Aiden by himself. He started unwrapping the chocolate bar and put it in his mouth, enjoying the rich and creamy taste of peanuts, the chocolate coating, and the layer of caramel. As he gulped it down, he continued to eat more of his candy. Aiden was on his fifth candy bar, a Twix bar. He unwrapped the shiny plastic that covered the candy bar and popped it into his mouth. The moment he chomped down on his first bite, he stopped and screamed in pain. The next moment after that, Aiden's parents immediately ran into the living room, and they were shocked by what happened to their son. His mother and father dragged him out of the house and drove him to the hospital. The whole way there was the most upsetting and terrifying experience for everyone in the car. It only took the doctors a few hours to fix Aiden up, his mouth still aching with the pain from the sharp objects that were punctured into his gums. Apparently, the Twix bar he bit into was filled with bits of sharp needles and razor blades, and it was a hard job to find all the pieces that were either sticking out or buried deep within his bleeding gums. While his parents sat in the waiting room at the time, impatient with how long it was taking for the doctors to patch Aiden up, one of the doctors was finishing up the job by stitching up the small cuts. As the job was completed, the doctor removed her latex gloves and threw them away in a nearby trash can.
"Do you feel better now, sweetie?"
the doctor said, a small, comforting smile appearing on her face as she tried to talk to Aiden, who was still touching the stitches with the tip of his tongue.
"Now, don't mess up the stitches, or you'll hurt your gums more."
"But I want them to hurt more,"
Aiden responded, leaving the doctor slightly confused.
"You must be joking, right? I'm sure you wouldn't really want that."
The doctor chuckled, hoping it was a dark joke from a child, which was sometimes normal for someone that young to say such things like that.
"No, I'm not. I enjoyed the pain. I want more of it."
Her eyes widened, no words to let out. All she could do was look at the strange child in front of her.
"What?"
"I want more pain. I love it. I want more of it."
The doctor nodded and walked out of her office, shocked to hear all of those things Aiden was saying. Surely it all must have been a joke, but something about it seemed quite off for her. She walked into the waiting room to get Aiden's parents, and led them into the office with her. The doctor and the worried parents had a conversation not only about the operation, which it turned out Aiden will be fine as long as he doesn't mess with the stitches, and that there was nothing wrong with the bits of razor and needles, but about Aiden's odd behavior. She also suggested them to make sure if there aren't any more candy with sharp objects in them in his collection. The parents took Aiden, left the hospital, and were able to dispose of all Aiden's candy in the trash. They had a talk with him about how he shouldn't go trick-or-treating anymore, with Aiden complaining about it since Halloween was his favorite holiday, and about his behavior at the hospital, with Aiden passing it off as a funny joke. They sent him to bed right after. Aiden woke up a few hours later. It was still dark and silent outside, except for some soft cricket chirps, and he felt his stomach rumble in hunger. He wanted to crave some more of the excruciating pain, a weird feeling no sane person would want. Getting out of bed, he quietly tiptoed out of his bedroom and into the kitchen, looking for what he needed. He knew for a fact that his parents only threw the candy away in the trash, but never took the bag out to the dumpster. So he went to the trash can and dug out some of the handfuls of candy bars. Aiden started drooling. He unwrapped a candy bar and popped it into his mouth. As he started chewing it, he noticed something different about this one. No sharp objects in it. For some reason, it tasted awful to him, but what made the other ones better to him? Was it the sharp pain that stung the insides of his mouth that he liked? Was it the taste of the coppery red blood that traveled down his throat? Aiden spat out the chewed remains onto the linoleum floor, then unwrapped another chocolate bar. He pulled it apart in half, noticing a few needles sticking out of both pieces. He was about to start eating them, but then he stopped because he heard a slight creaking sound in the kitchen. Aiden quickly turned around, noticing a dark figure in the kitchen with him. He couldn't make out who or what it was, but he knew for sure that it wasn't his mother or father. The tall figure walked closer to him, stepping out of the darkness to reveal himself as a man in a black suit and a brimmed hat, but Aiden couldn't see his face much. All he was able to make out was his wide smile, but there was something about that smile that didn't seem right. Each tooth in his smile had different layers of colors. There were stripes of yellow, then orange, then white. His teeth were made out of candy corn.
"I see you're enjoying my treat," the mysterious man said, bending down to face Aiden. His voice was dull and low, chilling enough to make poor little Aiden's little hairs raise up on the back of his neck. "Go ahead, take a bite, you know you want to," the man said. Then Aiden started unwrapping each candy bar and shoving it all into his mouth. He opened his mouth at times when chewing, feeling bits of needles and razors stick into his gums and the insides of his mouth. Blood started dripping down his chin and onto the floor.
"Very good, my boy. Very well done."
Aiden looked up at the tall man after finishing. He wanted more.
Who are you?
he asked, his voice trembling as he attempted to look into wherever his eyes would be.
I have no name, but you can call me the Candyman, the one who provides the perfect candy every year on Halloween for little girls and boys just like you.
The man replied, his candy corn smile getting wider.
Is there any more left?
Aiden asked, barely gurgling from the blood in his mouth. The candy man only laughed softly, then loudly, possibly loud enough to shake the whole house and wake Aiden's parents up. Then he bent down to face him directly in the eyes, only except Aiden could see that his eyes were pale jawbreakers. It seems as if this man is made from candy. His teeth were candy corn and his eyes were big jawbreakers, and possibly his whole body too. Aiden wasn't sure how to feel about it. He was scared out of his wits, indeed, but at the same time he felt an urge of hunger and pain.
Well, boy, why don't you put on your ghost costume and come trick-or-treating with me?
The Candyman asked, his breath giving off a cotton candy scent as he spoke.
Halloween may be over, but the night isn't.
And so, little Aiden quietly went into his bedroom and put on his blanket sheet ghost costume and grabbed his pillowcase to take with him. After that, the Candyman grabbed a hold of his hand and walked out of the house and into the quiet streets to have some fun. His parents hadn't woken up from the commotion and were unaware of their child's disappearance. Little did they know what would happen to their son the next morning. The Candyman and Aiden went into each house on the block, looking for sharp objects for the boy to ingest. Going into one of the houses, Aiden walked into the kitchen to look through the cabinets, figuring out what to eat, and his stomach rumbled even more. He pulled out a porcelain plate, smashed it into pieces on the counter, and started picking them up. He pulled up his ghost costume, holding a small shard of glass over his mouth and released it, gulping it down in a painful yet satisfying swallow. He could feel the sharp edges of the glass shard cutting down into his throat as he swallowed it. The loud smashing sound had woken someone up, because he and the Candyman heard footsteps coming down the stairs. An adult man in his nightshirt and underwear walked into the kitchen, noticing the commotion coming from the child in the ghost costume.
"Who are you?"
the adult shouted at him, holding a wooden baseball bat in his hand.
"What the hell are you doing in my house?"
The man didn't seem to notice the Candyman in the kitchen with him, just Aiden with the mess he had made. It was as if he couldn't see him, even though the lights were on, as if he wasn't there at all.
"Get out of my house or you'll get yourself in some serious trouble!"
The man shouted again, raising his bat towards Aiden. The boy stood frozen in fear, his eyes only focused on the weapon in the man's hand. The man charged over to Aiden, swinging his bat around as the intruder attempted to dodge every swing that came towards him. The Candyman sat on the counter, watching the cat-and-mouse game take place in the kitchen of the stranger's house. Good thing Aiden was a fast kid despite his diet and sugar, and now sharp objects, and was able to outrun him through the house. Eventually, the Candyman hopped off the counter and stuck his leg out, tripping the man. He tumbled forward and landed head first onto the edge of the coffee table, instantly knocking out the man. A thin cut appears on his forehead, then some blood starts oozing out. Aiden stopped and looked down at the man.
"Don't worry, he's not dead yet,"
the Candyman said before kneeling down and biting down into his neck. Blood starts spurting everywhere, even on Aiden's blanket sheet. The man's body twitched as he teared into his flesh, chomping down on it. A few minutes later, most of his dead body was now partially eaten. The Candyman got up and wiped his mouth with his jacket sleeve. Then Aiden started vomiting through his costume, mostly blood chunks, bits of chocolate, and some of the sharp objects.
"Now he is. Boy, go finish up your treat."
Aiden nodded and walked into the kitchen to finish eating some of the leftover shards of glass. After he finished, the Candyman took him to more houses to eat some more sharp objects, including nails, sewing needles, and glass shards. Aiden went into the kitchen of one house, digging through the silverware drawer. He pulled out a kitchen knife. He looked at his reflection on the blade, knowing what he was about to do next. The Candyman stared at the knife in the child's hand. He knew it was about to get interesting. Aiden gripped the handle and opened his mouth wide, shoving the knife in his mouth. he managed to push the knife down his throat. A mouthful of blood spilled out of his mouth. It came out like a crimson waterfall. His mouth was so full of his body fluids he couldn't even keep it in. The blood sloshed onto the floor, getting Aiden's clothes and shoes soaked. It was a bloody mess, and the Candyman watched. He stopped and started choking on the knife, since it didn't go down his throat all the way, which was also filled with more blood. He started clawing onto his neck, the pain now unbearable to him. The Candyman grinned at him as Aiden struggled to breathe. He was now very close to a painful death. Aiden fell over, but he didn't move a muscle. The next morning, the sun had risen and the boy's parents had woken up. Mr. Miller got out of bed, walking into the hallway and Aiden's bedroom door. He knocked lightly on the door, waiting for a response. He didn't hear anything, so he knocked again.
"Aiden, are you all right in there?"
Mr. Miller asked, chuckling nervously, knocking again. He didn't hear anything. He opened the bedroom door and saw Aiden in his ghost costume, lying down on the floor, completely motionless.
"Aiden!"
Mr. Miller crouched down and tapped him, but he didn't respond. He pulled back the sheet and started screaming. His wife came up from behind, noticing Aiden's dead body on the floor. Loud screams and ambulance sirens had filled the quiet neighborhood. The bodies of a child and an adult had been found dead. It was a strange mystery. Most of it was kids that had been found with sharp objects inside their bodies, often a body or two a year around Halloween. Maybe Halloween just wasn't safe for children, knowing that the candy they had collected might contain sharp objects in them. However, the thing that was off-putting about this was why the bodies were found with lots of it inside them. Nobody knew why it was happening, and it scared them just thinking about it. Somewhere in the neighborhood, there was an old, run-down house where the Candyman lived. The same one where Aiden had last collected candy at, and he waited for next Halloween to have his next victim take some of his delicious and savory candy.